हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू राउत साइंस। आई एम लोकनाथ। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग मीन्स रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए टेक्नोलॉजी, ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन ओपीएससी एंड यूपीएससी एज फार एज योर सिविल सर्विस कंसर्न्ड। ओके, सो व्हाट इज जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग? जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग मीन्स द टेक्नोलॉजी, द जीन्स आर बोथ applied in the field of engineering. That means when engineering and technology is applied to the biological things, the genetic material, then it is called art genetic engineering. That means engineering technology along with biology, that means genetic materials, that is genetic engineering, nothing but otherwise it is called as recombinant DNA technology. Recombinant DNA technology, because the genetic material, otherwise called the DNA, is recombined to form a number of clones or number of beneficial purposes. But how it takes place? What is genetic engineering? What is recombinant DNA technology? What is recombinant DNA? That a recombinant DNA technology or RDTA is nothing but the biological engineering, the biological manipulation of genetic materials for the benefit of, for the beneficial purpose of human beings. Is it right? So otherwise you can say that we genetic materials with the help of scientific technologies, principles, and so that it can benefit us. So let us see how it's taking place. So before that, I'm going to discuss who discovered this genetic technology. So three persons are very important in this regard. We can say Herbert W. Bayer, number one, Stanley N. Coole, next one, Paul Barth. Okay, Herbert W. Bayer, number one, Stanley N. Coole, next, and Paul Barker. These three persons are individuals are worked a lot in this regard to producing or bringing this technology to the world, okay, to the beneficial or benefit of humanity in particular. To see how it, let us see some terms. So as I have told already, the genetic engineering is nothing but the engineering applied to genes, number one. Number two, the recombinant DNA technology, nothing but it is synonymous as genetic engineering, or otherwise you can say biological engineering. So biological engineering, genetic engineering, recombinant DNA technology are all similar terms. Okay, you see, number one, so there is some, what are the terms are there? Restriction endonuclease. There, let us see, the genes are cut at a particular, at the required site, required part, required position, that is cut by an enzyme. That enzyme is called endonuclease, restriction endonuclease, which is called the molecular seizure or biological seizure, which cut the genes at the particular or the required sites. Is it right? That is called endonuclease. It is of two types, that is the restriction endonuclease, restriction exonuclease. Restriction endonuclease cut the gene, endo means within the part, under se cut karta, but restriction exonuclease cuts from the out, in the terminal ends, terms from the end. If it is cut in the interior portion within the genes, then it is endonuclease. If it cuts outside the terminal part, that is called exonuclease. Is it right? Number one, restriction endonuclease, which is called the molecular seizure or biological seizure. It is very helpful to the prelim point of view. Number two, ligase. Ligase is an enzyme which joins the cut piece of genes when required. The cut piece of genes, you see, like this, they are joined. You see, these are joined together. And this joint take place with the help of an enzyme that is called ligase, which is called the glue or gum of the engineering technology. That is what we can say, the biological glue or gum, which joins to cut piece of what genes. Next, restriction endonuclease, biological seizure, and cuts, and ligase, which joins or glue or gum. Next is vector. Vector means what vector? So when we cut the genes, it is placed, it is inserted, it is joined with another piece of whole gene, genetic material, so that it can be inserted in the host body and where it can multiply. So that, and generally the vector is that piece of gene which carries the required genes or the target genes and along with it, so that multiplication will take place, and that is nothing but the plasmid. Plasmid is a extra nucleus genetic material of bacteria. Is it right? So plasmid is called the vector for this technology. Remember, it is very important for film point of view. So plasmid is a vector. Number four, host. Host means after cutting, after joining, after inserting the plasmid or vector, then it is inserted another organism, generally the bacteria, which replicates itself, multiplies itself. Replicates means multiplies into large numbers. So we can get the required numbers of genes, fragments. So that is called a host body. Here host is bacteria. Again, to restriction and nucleus, molecular seizure. Ligates, the gum or glue, and vector is plasmid, and host is the body, generally the bacteria in which the system, the total system is inserted or put. So next come the steps. What are the steps of this genetic engineering or biological engineering? Number one, isolation of genes. What type of genes you need? For what purpose you genes are need? So that genes are isolated, extracted from the required part or required organism. That is called isolation of, number one step, isolation of genes or genetic materials. Number two, cutting the genes. After isolation, you just cut it. Where you need? What purpose you need? So it is cut. With which? Or with whom? With molecular seizure, that is restriction and nucleus. So it is cut at the targeted site, having the required number of base pairs, is it right? Next one is amplifying. So amplifying and multiplying large number of cut fragments, it is done generally in polymer chain reaction, PCR. You must have listened to this word, PCR technology, polymerase chain reaction, which was discovered by Karimulis. The polymerase chain reaction, it is done in a polymerase chain reaction machine under certain temperature, particular 70 degrees Celsius. So that temperature, it multiplies into large number of fragments. That is called amplification or amplifying of the genes. So this is the third step: isolation, cutting, then amplifying, then ligation, joining. Ligation is application of a ligage enzyme. So this is a joint. After amplification, they are joined. Then it is inserted. The first step is the insertion of the recombinant DNA. After joining, this is called recombinant DNA, and that recombinant DNA is inserted in the host body so that it can multiply into large numbers. These are the steps. So I have told the some new points like restriction under nucleus, plasmid, and vector, host, ligation, and your amplification PCR, and who discovered Karimulis, who discussed our recombinant technology, also I've told you. And then steps after that, what are the benefit or beneficial of purpose of this? Number one, ELISA test. For ELISA test, enzyme linked immuno servant assay. So that means the treatment of or test of HIV, human immunodeficiency virus, that is AIDS. Number one, gene therapy. Therapy, what is gene therapy? Therapy matlab genetic therapy. You can use genes as a therapy instead of using any surgical or any medicinal purpose. So that means if you have some genes of some organs are damaged or deleted or mutated, it can be replaced with a new part of that gene. New gene can be inserted in place of the older genes. That is called gene therapy. Using the genes for repairing, total altering the genes, either it may be repairing the genes or total alteration of the genes, total it is separate, deleted. So number one. Next is agriculture level. It is very important section is agriculture. You must have seen the GM crops, genetic modified crops. The genetic GM foods, GM modified cottons, brinjals, you must have seen other grains are produced. So this is called genetically modified crops. You might BT brinjal. You must have seen bituminous thuringes, the bacteria which helps in bituminous, that is called bituminous thuringes, that is a bacteria which is inside the brinjals, the genes of the brinjal, so that it can quality and quantity can be improved without the harmful effect of the pest micro insects like this. Because these bituminous thuringes is very resistant toward the pests and insects, and this is inserted the brinjal gene. When the brinjal gene and the bacteria gene is joined together, then a new variety, hybrid variety is formed, that is called Betty brinjal, that means bituminous thuringes. So not only the, as we have developed agricultural genetically modified crops and different hybridized varieties can be improved to pest resistance, insect resistance, water resistance, or like this variety of drought resistance you can also produce. Next is cloning which you must have seen, that Dolly was the clone to sheep, which was done at 1997 by the researcher. So that means it can be cloned. Cloning means again, what is cloning means? Cloning means take a piece of cells from anywhere of the body and it replicates for me. Just see, as I told you, the Dolly sheep was made from the what? Not from the genetic material, not from the germ cells. It is from the somatic cells. That is not sex cells. It is from the germ, somatic cells, from the odor of the goat sheep, and it is multiplied. And it is cloned, and the new organisms born from this isolated genes or isolated cells in laboratory, that is called cloning. Cloning, clone, a large number of a group of a gathering of cells, clone. So this is called cloning. So these are the applications of what? Genetic engineering. So this is the what? A small lecture, somewhat lecture. I think it will be very beneficial to you for the what mains and prelim purposes. So recommended DNA technology or genetic engineering, biological engineering, all the same things, and you just keep in mind. So finally, I am going to make it a summary to prelim purpose of you. Restriction under nucleus, cutting the DNA, biological seizure, molecular seizure, ligase, the glue or gum which joins the genes, plasmid is the vector which carries the particular gene, and host is the bacteria through which the plasmid is inserted, and the PCR is polymerase chain reaction, that is discovered by Karimulasi for the amplifying or multiplying large number of genes. Next, genetic food, genetically modified food or GM foods, and bituminous thuringes is the bacteria which forms the Betty brinjal or Betty cotton, like these things. And finally, we are going to do cloning. Dolly sheep, we have already learned about the Dolly sheep. Okay, this is all about this present session. And thanks to everybody.